Greetings to all my dear students. I am Shobha, Science Faculty, Mangala Vidya Mandira. Today, let us learn about some terms used in our science. Among that, the first one is acid. Acid is a molecule capable of donating positively charged hydrogen ion, that is H+ ion. These acids are sour to taste. They change the color of the litmus paper from blue to red. Some of the acids are corrosive in nature. There are two types of acids, that is natural and artificial. Natural acids are like citric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, formic acid, etc. Artificial acids are like sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, etc. The next term which we are going to learn is base. Base is a molecule capable of donating negatively charged hydroxyl ion, that is OH- ion. This base are bitter to taste. Soapy to touch, they change red litmus paper to blue color. Some of the examples of bases are ammonia, urea, baking soda, magnesium hydroxide, etc. Some of the chemical bases are like borax, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, etc. The third term which we are going to study is evaporation. The process by which an element or a compound transits from liquid state to gaseous state below its boiling point is called as evaporation. This is a particular process in which liquid water enters the atmosphere as water vapor. Drying of wet air, evaporation of nail paint remover, drying of wet floors are some of the examples of evaporation process. The next in term is vaporization. Conversion of a substance from liquid state to gaseous state at its boiling point is called as vaporization. The best known example is separation of mixture, that is separation of seawater from salt. The next term we are going to study is dilution. Dilution is nothing but the process of decreasing the concentration of solute in a solution, usually by mixing some solvent like water. For example, if you take 50 ml of water, add a teaspoon of sugar to it, that is solute. Further, you dilute it by adding another 50 ml of water. Then this process is called as dilution, and the solution is called as diluted solution. The next term we are going to study is enzyme. This is a most commonly used term in our biology class, where this enzymes are produced in the living organisms, act as a catalyst to bring about certain specific biochemical reactions. Example, amylase, zymase, lipase, etc. For example, this amylase, they convert the complex carbohydrate molecule into a simpler carbohydrate molecule. The last and the final term that we are going to study today is catalyst. This is the most common term used in our chemistry class. It is a substance that increases the rate of a chemical reaction without itself undergoing a permanent change. There are many examples of catalysts like nickel, palladium, etc. They increase the speed of the reaction without undergoing any change. Okay students, today we are learn about some terms in science. Further, in the next session, we are going to learn some more terms. Here are some of the questions for your home assignment, which you have to complete and WhatsApp. Thank you.